subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. As the monsoon season arrives in India, the country gears up to enjoy the pleasant weather and the beautiful festivals that are celebrated with dancing, singing and feasting. Haryali Tej is one among the monsoon festivities on which both married and unmarried women worship goddess Parvati to have a blissful married life or to get a good husband in the future. Though this year, amid the pandemic situation, no big gatherings were organized, but people still did not let the festive spirit dampen and observe the occasion at their own residence. Take a look.
Decked up in traditional attire, both women and small girls in Jaipur city of Rajasthan observe the otherwise vibrant Hindu monsoon festival of Haryali Tej in silence this year due to the COVID-19 outbreak. The pink city that used to witness a number of colorful processions comprising various folk and traditional dances every year was missing the exuberance this time. Regarded as a fasting festival of Hindu married women, the occasion commemorates the day when Lord Shiva accepted goddess Parvati's love for him. Celebrated on the third day of the bright half of the Indian lunar month of Shravan, the festival is observed with great fanfare in different parts of the country, but this year, due to the virus outbreak, it turned out to be a low-key affair.
हम तीज का त्यौहार बड़ी धूमधाम से मनाते हैं लहरिया लाते हैं घेवर मंगवाते हैं मेहंदी लगवाते हैं झूला झूलते हैं और खूब सारी लेडीज सब इकट्ठी होकर अच्छे से मनाते हैं
लेकिन इस बार फीका रहा
हां इस बार फीका रहा क्योंकि कोरोना की वजह से घर घर वाले ही सब मिलके मना रहे हैं तीज
Meanwhile, married women in Moradabad city of Uttar Pradesh also rejoice the festival at their home. They kept fast for the happiness in their marital relationship and in the evening, they broke the fast after performing all the rituals that are meant to appease the god and goddess.
ये त्योहार जो हम मनाते हैं इसीलिए मनाते हैं कि शिव माता पार्वती ने शिव को पाने के लिए 107 बार जन्म लिया था और 108वें जन्म पे उन्हें माता पार्वती को शिव जी पति के रूप में प्राप्त हुए थे तभी से ये परंपरा चली आ रही है और इस माह के महीने में हरियाली इतनी होती है चारों तरफ हरियाली हरियाली दिखाई देती है तो बहुत अच्छा सा लगता है सावन के महीने में तो हम जो है इस त्यौहार को और अच्छे से मनाते हैं और पार्वती माता की और शिव जी की पूजा करते हैं
Symbolic of the prosperity and happiness of married couples, the three-day festival provides a great opportunity for the ladies of different age groups and communities to come together and to be part of something special.
India India is a secular country where all the religions are treated with equal honor and respect. Mutual tolerance and regard for other religions has been the country's age-old tradition, and several examples upholding this tradition can be found at its every nook and corner. One such example is a Muslim man from Raipur city of Chhattisgarh who has undertaken the 800-kilometer long journey to attend Ram Temple's groundbreaking ceremony in Ayodhya.
As the entire nation is eagerly waiting for 5th of August to witness the groundbreaking ceremony of the construction of Lord Ram's temple at his birthplace Ayodhya, one man from Raipur has decided to travel 800 kilometers to be a part of this auspicious ceremony. Despite being a Muslim, Faiz Khan is an adamant believer of Lord Ram, and it is his faith in him that give him the courage to make this decision. Faiz started his journey from Chandkuri village of Chhattisgarh on 23rd of July, and his goal is to reach Ayodhya before the ceremony on the 5th of August.
Raipur se Ayodhya ki duri 800 km hai. हमने आज 23 जुलाई 2020 को सुबह 10 बजे जयस्तंभ चौक से ये पदयात्रा प्रारंभ की है और 4 अगस्त 2020 को हमारा पहुंचने का लक्ष्य है ताकि 5 तारीख के शिलान्यास के कार्यक्रम में सम्मिलित हुआ जाए।
Along with him, Faiz is carrying the soil of Chandkuri village for the foundation laying ceremony at Ayodhya. Chandkuri is said to be the birthplace of Kaushalya, the mother of Lord Ram, and thus it is home to Lord Ram's maternal grandparents. Faiz feels it is important to mix the soil of the birthplace of Ram's mother in order to seek blessings from the Lord before the construction of the magnificent temple. Apart from his family and friends, almost everyone is applauding this step of Faiz and is also helping him in possible ways to reach Ayodhya on time.
छत्तीसगढ़ जो भगवान श्री रामचंद्र जी का ननिहाल है, जो कौशल प्रदेश के नाम से जाना जाता था, वहीं की माता कौशल्या है। कौशल प्रदेश चंदपुरी नामक गांव रायपुर से 20 किलोमीटर वो माता कौशल्या का जन्म स्थान है, भगवान श्री रामचंद्र जी का ननिहाल है। वहां से हमने ये मिट्टी ली है क्योंकि भगवान श्री रामचंद्र जी का मंदिर अभी जो भूमि पूजन होने वाला है, सभी मंदिरों की, सभी महासागरों की, सभी पवित्र नदियों की वहां पर मिट्टी और जल अर्पित किया जा रहा है। मैं उनके ननिहाल से ये मिट्टी और जल का अंश लेकर जा रहा हूँ, उस भूमि पूजन में एक भेंट कर सके।
Right now, Faiz has reached Anuppur district in Madhya Pradesh, which is approximately 300 kilometers away from Raipur, the place from where he started his journey. Examples like Faiz are an inspiration for all, and are playing a significant role in maintaining communal harmony and strengthening the secular bond of the nation.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
A COVID-dedicated hospital in Vadodara is undertaking beautification work to paint its interior walls. The paintings reflect the nature and feel-good factor. Moreover, in order to promote cleanliness and creativity, artists depicted nature through grass. The aim is to imbibe positivity among the patients and help them heal faster.
तो ये सिचुएशन में से लोगों को कितने फास्ट उभरने के लिए पॉजिटिव एनर्जी चाहिए, एक तो हम लोगों ने खास ध्यान रखा है नेचर के साथ पेशेंट को डील किया जाए, तो हम लोगों ने ग्रास लिए हैं, फ्लावर्स लिए हैं, पेबल्स लिए हैं, तो ये सब नेचर की आइटम हम लोगों ने सिलेक्ट कर करके उसको डिज़ाइन में इनकॉर्पोरेट किया है, प्लस डिवोशन और स्पिरिचुअल भी हम लोगों ने खास ध्यान रखा है।
Till now, the target is of 100 rooms, but if the need arises, around 500 rooms will be designed further in such a manner.
Members of the transgender community along with volunteers in Chennai city of Tamil Nadu came together waging a war against deadly coronavirus by spreading awareness through dance and songs. Donning colorful dresses, the members of the transgender community were seen dancing in circles and telling people about the protective measures to be taken to brave the disease.
The lockdown and overall COVID-19 situation, we have been collaborating with Greater Chennai Corporation last 2 months for creating awareness and prevention and control program in the Chennai city.
People and organizations across the country are contributing their bit to create awareness and find out new ways to fight the pandemic.
An octogenarian woman in Pune city of Maharashtra has grabbed eyeballs by performing stunts with sticks with sheer agility. A video of 85-year-old Shanta Pawar performing Lati Kati, an Indian traditional baton martial art on the city streets, has been trending on social media in India.
मैं है ना एक थाली लेके जाती हूँ और एक छड़ी काढ़ी लेती हूँ ऐसे जोर से बजाती हूँ तो खान 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 ऐसे बजाते हैं तो क्या बजता करके लोग देखते हैं तभी मैं ये लाठी घुमाना चालू करती हूँ तो वो लोग देखते हैं फिर देख के मुझे देते हैं पेट के लिए मदद करते हैं तो किधर मेरे को 50 रुपया 100 रुपया किधर 20 रुपया ऐसा मैं दिन भर करते रहती हूँ
Pawar has been performing the martial arts since she was 8 years old and continues to do so with pride. Her performance has also caught the attention of the Bollywood celebrities.
The Chandigarh administration is set to introduce an emergency tree ambulance service that would cater to the needs of rotting and unhealthy trees in the Union Territory. A phone number has also been released by the administration so that people can contact them whenever they see a tree in a bad condition.
This is an emergency service, like you must have heard about ambulance for human being, ambulance for animals, like we also do have wildlife ambulance for rescuing of wild animals. In the similar concept, we are going to start services called emergency services for the trees. Like, for example, you must have come across few trees in Chandigarh especially affected by termites or other insects and all. In case people they come across such trees, affected trees, they can call the department and the department vehicle and person, they will be in readiness. So they can attend to the call and treat the trees.
Almost all the formalities are complete and the service is going to start soon.
Domicile certificates were recently issued to West Pakistani refugees in Jammu city of Jammu and Kashmir. The refugees had been demanding domicile as they say they have lived in the Union Territory for more than 70 years. According to the new law that was put into place last year after revocation of Article 370, the Jammu and Kashmir authorities have been authorized to issue domicile certificates to the refugees if they fulfill the new norms like the term of their stay in India. The refugees who were happy to receive permanent residency said the certificate would enable them to buy land and allow their children to apply for jobs in India.
अभी हमारे बच्चे जो है वो नौकरी के लिए भी अप्लाई कर सकते हैं सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट के लिए भी स्टेट के लिए भी इंजीनियरिंग करें चाहे टीचर के लिए करें हर एक जगह अप्लाई कर सकते हैं। पहले हम जहाँ पर जमीन नहीं खरीद सकते थे, अभी हम जमीन भी खरीद सकते हैं, अपने मकान जमीन के लिए मकान भी खरीद सकते हैं। तो सबसे ज़्यादा बेहतर ये वेस्ट पाकिस्तान के रिफ्यूजियों के लिए अधिकार मिला हमारे को।
Hindu and Sikh refugees migrated to Jammu city from undivided Punjab province during the 1947 partition when India and Pakistan became separate countries to escape religious persecution.
As the Indian government is busy battling coronavirus outbreak, a number of citizens and organizations too are not behind in extending their support to the needy people who are worst affected by this pandemic, be it through distributing essential items, study material or oxygen cylinders. People have been contributing their bit without making any discrimination on the basis of caste and community. So let's take a look at few such examples.
A couple, Migza and Fayaz Sheikh, who run a small-scale school at Mumbai's Malad area, waived off the fees of the students when they found that their parents could not afford to pay the fees amid the lockdown. But they did not just stop here. When they got to know that the people living in the area could barely afford 2 square meals a day, they decided to donate rations to them. 4 months down the line, the couple has spent around 4 lakh rupees from their personal savings and distributed food items to about 1,500 people, no matter which caste or community they belong to.
When lockdown started, after 4 or 5 days, they started calling us, the students, the parents, because they found some hope in me. They must be thinking ki I can help them out. So then when they started, we both came, my husband and myself, to see what is happening over here, because we were also scared of the COVID, so we were not stepping out. But when they started calling us, we thought ki we should visit this area. So when we visited here, their condition was very worse. So at that time, we approached many NGOs. They started giving us support in the form of khichdi also. Then we started continuing distribution of khichdi for two months. We were distributing khichdi to community. Not just parents, just a whole community over here. That lockdown extended, we all know that extended for 4 months. So that time we both sat and decided ki we can't keep money in our account and let them suffer with hunger. So that time we decided to dilute that money to these people and distribute ration.
Meanwhile, a specially abled person in Rameswaram town of Tamil Nadu is providing door-to-door service of distributing Kapusura Kudinir among the people. It is an herbal concoction comprising dry ingredients of ginger, pipli, clove, muli root, karukai, ajwain and many other herbs. The ingredients are powdered and mixed with water, then boiled to make a decoction of 1/4 of its initial volume. As it has proved effective in managing COVID-19 cases, Dina started serving it to the general public.
நான் வந்து கடந்த ஒரு 15 நாட்களா வந்து இந்த கபசுர குடிநீர் வந்து நானே வீட்ல தயார் பண்ணி இந்த பகுதியில் இருக்கிற மக்களுக்கு எல்லாத்துக்கும் வந்து நான் வந்து இலவசமாக கொண்டு போய் அவங்க வீட்ல குழந்தைகள் பெரியவங்க பெண்கள் முதியோர்கள் இந்த மாதிரி எல்லாருக்குமே வந்து இதை கொடுத்துக்கிட்டு இருக்கேன். நான் வந்து ஒரு மாற்றுத்திறனாளியாக இருந்தாலும் இந்த சமூகத்துக்கு ஒரு பெரிய மாற்றத்தை கொண்டு வரணும், எல்லார் மத்தியிலையும் இந்த மாதிரியான ஒரு பண்பை உருவாக்கணும் அப்படின்ற நோக்கத்தில் நான் வந்து கடந்த ஒரு 10-15 நாளாக இதை செஞ்சுக்கிட்டு இருக்கேன். தொடர்ந்து இதை நான் செய்வேன் இந்த காரியங்களை. இது போக வந்து இந்த பகுதியில் இருக்கிற எல்லா மக்களுக்கும், அதாவது இந்த மாவட்டம் முழுவதும் இந்த கபசுர குடிநீரை கொடுக்கணும் அப்படின்றது என்னுடைய நோக்கம். அது நிச்சயமாக நிறைவேறும் என்று நான் நம்புகிறேன்.
At present, when the whole country is reeling due to coronavirus, in such a situation, it's people like Migza and Dina who are coming forward and extending the support in the fight against the pandemic.
It is said that disability is just a matter of perception, and the only disability one can have is a bad attitude. It is therefore important to stop treating it as a limitation and focus towards providing equal opportunities to specially abled people. One such organization that is working in this direction is the Nagaland-based Deaf Biblical Ministry that is working towards the betterment of specially abled people even amid this pandemic situation. Atula was born with a hearing and speech impairment. She stitches clothes and weaves plastic bags for earning a living. Harimi Rungsung is a successful entrepreneur. She is a professional hairdresser and runs a beauty salon. Both Atula and Harimi are members of the Deaf Biblical Ministry, an organization situated in Dimapur district of Nagaland and is dedicated towards the betterment of specially abled people. Amid this time of crisis, this organization has turned out to be a boon for these people, and it is helping them to find work and lead a respectable life.
She does stitching clothes and then basket making as well as embroidery. And whenever she gets time, she used to go for wedding planner with favors. Right now, she's teaching masks for Act of Kindness. In future, she's going to collaborate with Act of Kindness, and then they will be coming up with, you know, new things.
Established in the year 1987, the Deaf Biblical Ministry has been working for years with the motive of providing opportunities to specially abled people as well as breaking the stigma of disability. The ministry that once started with just 9 children is today working 24/7 to achieve its mission. It is also providing educational and vocational training along with American Sign Language classes to these people to open the door to opportunities and jobs for them.
The Deaf Biblical Ministry was established by my parents in 1987. So during that time, there was not much awareness, almost zero. Actually, I think there was zero awareness about most of the disabilities, and especially about the deaf as well. So when they started the ministry, my parents did have a lot of difficulties bringing awareness. Many people did not want to bring their child forward because there was still that stigma about disability that time.
The DBM ministry till date has not only trained lakhs of specially abled people but has also helped them in becoming self-reliant and reaching greater heights. That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.